Hey, what's up, you guys? Yes, it's 34 degrees this morning. It was sort of hard to write on the window. It was so tough right there. But anyway, let's see what we got to get done today, you guys. Hi, baby. Hi, baby. Hi. 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 All right, you guys, what have we been doing? We've been getting some tractors and mowers ready for some mowing around the field. We got the side cutter hooked up to the 7320 here. And we got the long arm cutter hooked up to the 78 and the bush hog hooked up to the 76 over there. We got all three of them parked over here because they needed welding. All three of them needed welding. There's a piece here that we need to change out that raises the deck up. Got a whole new piece there that needs to be changed. But the slides down there on the bush hog, had to replace them on there, get that welded on. And we got the long arm cutter hooked up Friday. Uh-oh, you guys, we got the long arm cutter hooked up. We're just gonna leave it right here for tonight though. And when Danny got it pulled over here, he said that it blew a hose. So I gotta figure out which hose it is and get it replaced. I can see a spot there that was welded. Yeah, this joker hadn't been run since 2017. So it might be a few more hoses that decide they want to go on out. But like I said, we got the duals on the 78 here and the duals on the 76 over here. And the bush hog needed some welding as well. The slides down here, new. So yeah, we're getting set up, you guys, to get mowed around the fields. And I get to run the long arm cutter, cut that big stuff. Oh yeah, I just thought about it too. We got to get the cage put on the side of the 78 over here to protect the glass. We got a little cage we made that will help protect it from the debris from flying into it. So I guess we'll be working on these things, trying to get them ready to go, you guys. So this is the part that has to be replaced here because this one has seen its best days, you guys. And of course, this nice shiny red piece is gonna look out of place, but that's okay. It'll get the job done the same, even though it'll be looking better than the rest of the side cutter. But anyway, we're gonna get to work. You guys, that was a pretty easy switch out. I hadn't got it on yet, but all I had to do is take the nuts off of this side of that long bolt and slide that whole thing off. And I'll just have to slide that back on there. And of course, use that round piece there. I'm gonna grease that entire thing up before I put the new one on there. And that way it'll be greased all the way around in there to begin with. But yeah, it's a pretty easy swap out. And we got it on, you guys. Got the new one on, good to go. I guess I'm gonna see if I can find the leak on this long arm cutter, you guys. Probably gonna have to work the controls to see where it spurts out at. Almost looks like there's some fluid right there on that hose there. He said it was a short one, so yeah, we're gonna work on it. Yep, I seen it. Where is it at? Okay, it's this one right here. This one right here, you guys. It's got that fluid running around it. So, I guess I'm gonna try and get it changed. It runs right here. Okay. All right, you guys, I got the hose off. I hadn't gone to go get it fixed yet, but I'm over here at the barn to get the guard that goes on the 78. These pieces here. And this is what goes over the side glass. Gonna get it loaded up on the trailer. That'll do it. All right, you guys, so we got the guard here on the 78. It took three of us to get it up there, but we got it. Dan pointed out to me that there's two more hoses that I should probably go ahead and get changed out back here, so I'm gonna get those two hoses off, and I guess after lunch I'll go and get them made and get them put back on and continue to get the long arm cutter serviced up and ready to go. All right, you guys, so I got all three of them off, and y'all got to help me remember that the middle one has the 90 degree angle on it, on that one end, okay? Help me remember that. So I'm gonna take lunch, and then after lunch, I'll go and have them made. All right, you guys, we headed to get these hoses made. Rudy's got the side cutter. He's working on them ditches. Are we gonna be able to say, look at them ditches when he's done? Alrighty, you guys, we have arrived. Filters and hydraulics. Run in here and get these three hoses made. All right, you guys, got the three hoses made and a bucket of AW68 hydraulic fluid for the long arm cutter. Let's head on back to the shop. All right, you guys, so we have arrived back at the shop. I'm going to get these hoses put on. I ran some water through them and blew them out with the compressed air like we always do. But I'm gonna see if I can get them put back on. All right, you guys, got the hoses on. I'm gonna crank it up and raise the arm up and make sure no more hoses wanna blow. I guess we're gonna see what it does. All right, you guys, so there's no blown hoses and it's functioning properly. The only thing is, I think Danny has the hoses hooked up differently from how I would normally operate them. Plus I'm rusty, so we'll get used to it and we'll set the hoses up in the correct lever controls in the tractor, how I normally run it. But I'm gonna pressure wash this thing off since it's been sitting for a few years. It's looking a little dirty here, so I'm gonna get it cleaned off, and I still got to grease up and check out some more things before I can even get to mowing. I won't get to mowing today, that's for sure. So I'm gonna continue to work on it. guys. I got it cleaned up a little bit. I didn't do a spectacular job. I just wanted to get that excess hydraulic fluid off of there. It had sprayed up on the windows from when that hose blew, and some of that old green mossy looking stuff that was on it. I just remembered too, I gotta sharpen the blades. I hadn't looked at them. I might need a new set under there. I don't know. But anyway, we just shall continue getting it ready. Gotta hook up the PTO and get it greased, like I was saying earlier. I'll probably do a lot of that stuff tomorrow. But yeah, you guys, we breaking out the long arm cutter this year. I'm excited. Hey, we gonna be making some chatter noise indeed this year. But anyway, I hope that you checked out part 3, getting it flowing at Mother Beaver Dam part A. Hey, we got it flowing, didn't we? If you hadn't seen it yet, you might as well go check it out, because there's some serious flow. But anyway, I'm going to wrap this video on up, you guys, and I guess we'll be checking back in tomorrow. Hopefully, we can get started somewhere tomorrow. I hope you guys enjoyed watching. Hey, Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. You guys stay blessed. Oh, wait a minute. Make sure you put a thumbs up for us and hit that subscribe button and the notification bell, because you ain't going to want to miss this. You hear me? You're not going to want to miss this. But anyway, throw a comment in the comment section. Let me know what's on your mind. In the meantime, in between time, you guys stay blessed. You guys keep encouraged. And as always, we'll see you in the next one.